Hello, welcome to our short video on how to design a single supply, low side, unidirectional current sensing circuit. This schematic represents a single supply, low side, unidirectional current sensing circuit. Current sensing circuits are used to convert and amplify an input current, also known as a load current, to an output voltage. This circuit is called low side because the sense resistor, R1, is connected to ground. Unidirectional means that the load current, I sub I, only flows in one direction. The gain of this circuit is composed of two parts. First, the sense resistor, R1, converts the load current, I sub I, into a voltage based on the value of its resistance. This voltage is called the sense voltage. Secondly, the sense voltage, or V sub I, is gained up by the non-inverting gain of the amplifier, which is 1 plus R3 divided by R2. This circuit is commonly used to convert a load current to a voltage so that it can be digitized by an analog to digital converter, or ADC. Since most ADCs are operated with a single supply voltage, the circuit is also designed to operate with a single supply. This video explains how to design this circuit using TI's TLV9062 in a few easy steps. The first design goal for this circuit is to convert a maximum input current of 1 amp to a maximum output voltage of 4.9 volts. In low side current sensing applications, it's common to set a maximum shunt voltage so the load's ground potential is nearly equal to that of the op amp and A to D converter. In this circuit, the maximum input voltage, or sense voltage, is set to 250 millivolts. In order to maintain a linear output, the minimum output voltage is set to 50 millivolts. Finally, an accuracy goal of 0.2% full-scale range error, or FSR error, is desired, and a single 5-volt supply is used because it is common for this type of circuit. The first design step is to calculate the maximum shunt resistance, R1, based on the maximum load current of 1 amp and maximum shunt voltage of 250 millivolts. To do this, we simply divide the maximum shunt voltage by the maximum load current, which yields a value for R1 of 250 milliohms. The next step is to calculate the gain of the non-inverting amplifier circuit such that the maximum shunt voltage of 250 millivolts corresponds to a maximum output voltage of 4.9 volts. To do this, we divide the maximum output voltage by the maximum shunt voltage, which yields a linear gain of 19.6 volts per volt. Next, we need to determine the resistor values for R3 and R2 that correspond to a non-inverting amplifier gain of 19.6 volts per volt. One easy way to do this is to use the Find Amplifier Gain function of the Analog Engineer's Calculator. Setting the type to non-inverting, target gain to 19.6 volts per volt, and using 0.1% resistors yields values of 13.3 kiloohms for R3 and 715 ohms for R2. You may have noticed that there is not a design goal for the minimum load current. That's because when designing this type of circuit, you can either start with the minimum load current and minimum shunt voltage, or use the maximums as we did in this case. Either way, the design is bound by the output swing limitations of the amplifier. In this case, we can use the minimum output voltage, gain, and shunt resistance to calculate the minimum load current that can be measured without violating the op amp's output swing specification. For this design, the minimum load current required for linear operation is 10.2 milliamps. Now let's check the full-scale range error. The full-scale range error is calculated by dividing the offset voltage of the amplifier by the shunt voltage range and multiplying by 100. The minimum shunt voltage is 10.2 milliamps times 250 milliohms, which is 2.55 millivolts. Using the typical offset voltage of the TLV9062, this yields a full-scale range error of just 0.12%. A DC sweep of the input current from 10.2 milliamps to 1 amp yields an output voltage from 55.4 millivolts to 4.91 volts. This verifies the functionality of the circuit. Running an AC sweep analysis, we find that the bandwidth of the circuit is 500 kHz. When designing low side current sensing amplifier circuits, there are a few design notes to be aware of. First, be sure to use an op amp whose common mode voltage, or VCM, includes ground. Next, be sure to always check the linear output swing of the amplifier, which is usually given in the conditions section of the AOL datasheet specification. Finally, if you're trying to detect a load current of 0 amps, you can use a negative charge pump like the LM7705 for your negative supply voltage. Texas Instruments has many online resources to help you design circuits with op amps. This includes reference designs and guides, educational videos, simulation and prototyping tools, support resources, and search tools. Thank you for taking the time to watch this short presentation on how to design a single supply, low side, unidirectional current sensing circuit. Please visit www.ti.com for additional information and resources.